Hey guys, so today we'll talk about supply and demand, the most basic building blocks of macroeconomics. And we'll also solve some practice problems to help you understand what it's all about. Let's start by setting up a graph. We have P, or price, on the vertical axis, and Q, or quantity, on the horizontal axis. So, the demand curve has a downward slope, and the law of demand states that the higher the price of a good, the less people will want to buy it. This makes sense. The more expensive something is, the less of it people will want. And likewise, the cheaper something becomes, the more of it people will buy. So, for example, if new iPhones all of a sudden became like $50, even all of you Apple haters will go out and buy one. Likewise, if a can of Pepsi was $50, you definitely would not buy it because it just wouldn't be worth it. And the supply curve has an upward slope, and the law of supply states that the higher the price, the more of a good will be created, meaning that once a company finds out that something can be sold for more money, they will begin making more of it. Think about it. If all of a sudden knitted scarves were selling for like $10,000, I'd bet you'd go out and learn how to knit because this would be an amazing job, and think about how rich your grandma would get. So these laws determine how the interactions between producers, the sellers, and consumers, the buyers, determine the price and the production quantity of certain goods or services. Now, let's talk about equilibrium. Consumers always want to get stuff cheaper, and producers always want to make more money. So who gets their way? Well, when both of them are happy, this is called an equilibrium, the point of intersection of the two lines, the demand and the supply curves. And this point is the optimal price of production and quantity of a good. It's usually denoted by P star and Q star, like this. Now, let's try to solve an example problem. We know that the quantity of demand is given by the function 2000 minus 40p, and the quantity of supply is given by 500 plus 10p. Now, Q obviously here is demand, and the index here, Q is quantity, and the index here is D, demand, and S, supply, and P is price. Now, in the first equation, it means that for every $1 increase in price, there will be minus 40 demand of the quantity. And in the Q of S, it means that for every $1 increase in price, companies will want to make 10 more of this thing, this product, whatever it is. Now, to get the equilibrium, obviously they have to equal each other. So let's set the two equations equal to each other. We have 2000 minus 40p. Equals 500 plus 10p. If we rearrange the equation, we get 1500 equals 50p, which means that the optimal price is $30. And now to get the optimal quantity, we just have to plug it into one of the equations. Let's plug it into this one. So we have Q equals 500 plus 10 times 30 equals 800. What does this mean? This means that in this economy, with these two quantity equations, we know that the optimal price and the optimal production quantity are 30 and 800. That's how much people will want to pay, and that's how much companies will want to make. Now, what if we have another situation where all of a sudden people get richer in this economy? Things are going well, people are making more money, so the demand curve will go up, it will increase. And the new equation, let's say it will be 3000 minus 40p, and the quantity of supply equation will stay the same, 500 plus 10p. What will be the new optimal price and quantity? Well, let's take a look. We set it up in the same way as before. We set the two equations equal to each other, and we have 3000 minus 40p equals 500 plus 10p. If we rearrange it, we get 2500 equals 50p, or the price is equal to $50. And we plug it in back into the first equation. We have 500 plus 10 times 50, 1000. So in this case, when people have more money, the new optimal price is 50, and the new optimal quantity is 1,000, which makes sense because if people have more money, they can buy more stuff and they're willing to spend more money for it. And this is what causes inflation. So check out one of our other videos if you want to learn more about inflation. Now let me ask you this. We know that if people have more money, the demand curve goes up, the price and the quantity will go up. But what do you think would happen if people have less money, the economy is doing badly, and the demand curve goes down? Pause the video now, think about it, and click in the upper right-hand corner, and we'll see if you're right or not. Now, if you chose the answer that the quantity will be lower and the price will be lower, then you're right, which makes sense. Think about it. If people have less money, they're going to be able to buy less stuff, and they won't be able to pay as much money for it. So that makes sense. Now, what if instead of the demand curve shifting, the supply curve shifts? If production becomes more expensive, the supply curve will shift up, increasing the prices and decreasing quantity. Let's take a look. So the quantity of demand equation will stay the same. It'll be 2,000 minus 40p. And the quantity of supply equation, because supplies are now more expensive, it will be 200 plus 10p. So let's set them equal to each other and find out the optimal values. We have 2,000 minus 40p equals 200 plus 10p. If we rearrange it, we get 1,800 equals 50p, or the price is equal to $36. And to plug it back in, we have 200 plus 10 times 36 equals 560. So that means in this case, when supplies become more expensive, the optimal price becomes $36, and the optimal quantity becomes $560. So let's review. In our normal economy, the equilibrium was $30, and the optimal quantity was 800 units. When the economy improved and people got richer, the demand curve shifted up, and the price and quantity increased to $50 and 1,000 units. But in the case when materials for manufacturing became more expensive, the supply curve shifted up, and the optimal price became $36, and the optimal quantity became $560. Note that in the third case, compared to the first case, the price is more expensive and the quantity is lower, so this is not good. This is an economy where people have to pay more for less stuff. That's not what we want. So I hope you guys like this video. Please subscribe and check out more stuff. Stay geekly, my friends.